Hey everyone, and welcome back to Joy at Work. I hope you're doing great and staying safe. It's October 1st, 2021, and it's Nigeria's Independence Day, and this is why I'm rocking this classic Super Eagles jersey. I probably need a new one at this point. Who knows, this might be nearly 20 years old. Okay, it's not that old, just a joke there. But nonetheless, it's Nigeria's Independence Day, so happy Independence Day to all of us, and it just got me thinking about the importance of autonomy, freedom, the ability to act in the workplace. This weekend, over the past weekend, I wrote an article titled Beyond Empowerment. It's on my blog, so check it out, where I made the point that having the ability to do your job is not being empowered. That's just having the ability to do your job. And I am frustrated a little bit with the corporate use of empowerment these days, because everybody says they want to empower their people. And I just interpret that as we want to let our people do their jobs, which is what it should be in the first place, right? And that's the independence and autonomy that we all look for. We know that a lack of autonomy really takes away from our fulfillment, from our enjoyment. We want to have the ability to do things out of our own volition and do them not because we're coerced. Nobody has unbounded autonomy, but all of us desire high levels of autonomy. And not only do we desire high levels of autonomy, we desire that our leaders provide us with support that enables autonomy. I've often said that as a leader, your actions either take autonomy away or promote and give more of it. Very rarely does it just leave things in the balance. I'm sure theoretically that's possible. But as a leader, and if you're a leader listening to this, just realize that when you act, you're either acting in a way that promotes autonomy, or you're acting in a way that takes away from it or reduces it. But each one of us desires autonomy. We desire freedom and liberation. So if you find yourself in a work situation where you don't have the autonomy that you should have. And what I mean by that is every job comes with a set of things that we should be able to do in that role, generally speaking, should be clearly defined. If you do not have the ability to do those things and do them well, do them ethically, do them morally, and you're constrained, then there's a problem. You're missing the autonomy that should be in that role. Now, it's important. Sometimes people think that they should have the autonomy to do X, when the role never had the autonomy to do X. And that's a separate conversation. That's where maybe you want to increase the scope of your autonomy. You need to have a conversation with somebody. And maybe you're justified in wanting to increase the scope of your autonomy. But at a basic level, you need to have the autonomy. You need to have the ability to act within the construct or the confines of the role as it is. So don't be deceived by this idea of we want to empower people. Be very clear on what your job entails and the power that comes with that position. And if you find yourself in a place where you don't have autonomy, where you're shackled and constrained, where you have to ask permission to do your job all the time, and asking permission to do your job is not the same as informing others of what you intend to do. We work with other people. It's good to make them aware of what we intend to do. I'm really talking about just seeking permission to do your job. Then you might want to think about doing something else, because when we don't have autonomy, it really impacts our ability to experience joy at work. So, hey, on this celebration for Nigeria, independence and freedom, a vlog on autonomy, a vlog on liberation, a vlog on being able to do your job and do it well because you have the freedom to do so. I hope that's your experience. If it's not, see what you can do to change things so that you can experience joy at work. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you later. Bye.